Hey, this is ASpengler, and this is episode 12 of building Itter Castle in Lego. Now, just right off the bat, we got some of those Bricklink orders that were supposed to come in last week, but now they come the day after I posted the video for last week, so it's kind of sad. So this is two of the four, so now I have three total of the four I sent out. So I'll show you guys that one later. I'll start out with these ones. This one had the grass in it. As you can see, I kind of underestimated. I think this is like 200 grass pieces. I didn't really think about it. This is probably not going to be enough. Also, you can see there's some brown rod pieces. I used those in the trees. Some more brown rod pieces plus some little slopes. And I hate it how sometimes they'll just put everything in one bag. So I guess there's road pieces in here. Some just bricks. So mainly bricks, road pieces. That's what I see. Haven't gone through it yet. Okay, here, this is the second order from, this one was from Bricks on the Dollar, but they gave me some free stuff, a little helmet, and I think that's maybe a Clone Army Customs helmet, I'm not sure. And there's like a Minecraft pickaxe, not sure where that's from, and then this shield from Brick Warriors, so that's some cool stuff. And they gave me this decal, castle decal, so that's, quick show you, cool castle decal. So that's just a shout out to Bricks on the Dollar for that. Thanks for that cool stuff. So now getting into the order. Apparently I bought some red or dark red bricks. I'm not sure why. Maybe I mistaken them for like the brown bricks. I think that's what happened, but I don't remember buying dark red bricks, so I'm a little confused on that. I probably just messed up. Some more trunk pieces for trees, road pieces, and a lot more tree bush pieces. Here's some actual bricks that I probably would need. The bricks, if I got any bricks, they're mainly for back there. I had to end up, at the end, I just ended up stacking. Basically, I just ended up stacking like a bunch of these long pieces together to make the same height as these. So I might go back, replace some of the ones that were just plates with actual bricks so I can get the plates back in case I need them. So there's some little brown pieces, probably for bushes. I just got a few of them because I'm not sure what I'll do with them yet. And then just a bunch more. I think I got 200 total dark green and 200 total regular green, so there should be enough there to make a decent amount more of trees and bushes. So that's the order. And also, on a kind of not related to the mock, I got some drawers or stack on drawers. Got four of these. Just yay more sorting. So for my birthday, so now I'll get more organized. I already have maybe like seven or eight so far. So just add four more. Now I'll have like 12. So get more organized. At the moment, I mainly just have a lot of gray pieces organized. But with these four new ones, I was hoping to also start organizing some more different colors that are used, like tans, greens, browns, those kind of mock colors, and also the blacks and whites for tanks and stuff like that. So just looking to widen so I don't have to dig through buckets, which takes a lot longer. It's a lot easier just pull a drawer and then get the piece right out. So I'll probably be doing a lot more sorting soon. So, but now that these Bricklink orders are in, or at least three out of the four, I got the two main ones that were focusing on trees. I got the grass one. I didn't get, the last one was mainly just focused on road stuff. So now that I have all the tree pieces that I ordered, I can get started right away on this segment, get it working on some trees. So I guess I didn't give you guys a quick view of the mock so far. So basically, we got some trees on the mock so far. I got a lot of castle or knights right there. So there's a few trees and bushes down so far. I got the grass down on about half the mock. I got the majority of the road done, except for, or go back there behind the Panzer IV. There, that little patch still needs to be done, plus the bridge there. So I'll probably start off on trees and then go to working on road once that Bricklink order comes in, plus maybe I'll do a little bit of maintenance work, but I won't really show that. Replacing some stuff, just some little maintenance work. As far as grass, I'll probably do that last, because when I'm adding trees, like if I was to plant a tree right there, I'd remove some of this grass. So then by the time I get all the new trees down, I will probably get some more grass. So then I probably will have enough. Hopefully I'll have enough to finish. Basically, it's just the side along this side needs some grass, and then about to here, going like around the mock on the other side. I'm probably gonna do something different. If you remember, back here on the other side, be next to those trees back there, it's more of the dark green. I was probably gonna do something that covers the ground with more, using these darker green things, kind of just as like vines or more like thicker brush on the ground. So with those Bricklink orders in now, I'll go ahead, stop talking, and start get working on those trees. Maybe I'll get some time lapses in this segment, probably will, because this work is more more interesting and easier to get a time lapse than like the last tree one I did. So I'll go ahead, stop talking, and get working. Come back to show you guys the progress so far. Right there you saw me working on just the regular green pine trees. I made two of those really big ones, one kind of regular, and then four of these smaller ones in front. At the moment I just did the green ones. I used about 2/3 of the green leaves that I ordered. I didn't go ahead and start working on the dark green pine trees because that Bricklink order that hadn't come in before had now come in. I took it out and they're in these bins. So I got like 75 of these light bluish gray brick or masonry brick pieces. Those will probably be for the castle. Here you just got some more dark tan plus some road detailing pieces. I got some just reddish brown bricks, and then finally some here's some reddish brown pieces, and then also it came with these like 400 brown studs. So that was that order. It was one of the more smaller ones out of the four. So now all the orders are in. I'll probably, instead of going to keep working on the trees, I'm gonna go ahead. I just really want to get this back part behind that Panzer IV finished of the road. So I'll go ahead and finish that. Maybe I'll just get while I'm working on the road, get started working on this area plus the bridge. Maybe I'll do the side part along the bridge. I'm not completely sure yet, but for sure I'll get working on this top area, the inside of the bridge, maybe do the outside, and then that back last little bridge. I'll probably at least get the time lapse on this last little back area. Probably won't put the trees in till towards the end, or when I'm doing grass, or at least I'll wait till I get some of the dark green pine trees in. So decent amount of work in so far. I'll go ahead, get working, try to finish off the road for this segment. So I'll go ahead and keep working. Show you guys the progress, but before I show you guys the mock, I forgot to show you guys earlier where I put those four new drawers. I don't think I've shown you my kind of Lego wall before. So before, I just had these bottom four here, plus like three in the closet. I got those four new ones that I showed you one of them earlier. So I got these all mounted up, so that's cool now. So I guess I don't think I've shown you my setup before. So this is basically where I have all my drawers plus those couple ones in the closet. That's where I keep most of my tanks lined up on top. They used to be on the first, but I just raised them. And then I got those four just minifigure display cases. I got six more of those, so 10 total minifig display cases. So that's just kind of a side thing. Here's my those drawers, kind of my setup of my Lego wall. Okay, so that's that. Now coming back to show you guys what I was just working on. You saw a little bit in that time lapse. I finished up the back road there. Could zoom in, show you guys that. Move that Panzer IV. So I completed that back bit of road, which is basically just from here where that regular green is, and kind of just onwards to the end. So I finished up that, and then I went ahead and got working on this area, so I put the dirt in here, but then I was originally gonna put a kind of a dirt road all across the bridge, but then I was looking at some more pictures and it seemed to be kind of more paved on the actual bridge, so instead of putting the same dirt pattern on, I just went ahead to put that cobblestone look on it, so that looks a little bit more like the pictures. I don't think it would have really mattered either way. It would have looked good either way, I think. This just goes a little bit more accurate. And in the end of that segment, I wasn't completely sure what I'd do for these little posts, but I found black kind of slanted pieces. This looks basically, I think, the closest I can get it to what it is in the pictures. I'll just have to order some more, because if you look back here, I do not have it on those back two ones. I ran out, or this is basically the only ones I had, and it was just as after the video I kind of put in, I was looking at the pictures, how it kind of extended off. It's kind of got this like little railing thing. It would have gone on both sides here. This, if I had more room, I would have had this also extend out here, but I ran out of room. If I was bigger, it would have kind of been mirrored, so this would have been the same on this side. I don't have the room to do that, so. And then it kind of goes into the stone wall, so. I think on the other side of the bridge, it also has this type of railing over here, so I'll probably do a little bit of that after. In the time lapse, you probably didn't really see the side detail a whole lot while I was in that time lapse, so I put these masonry bricks just kind of like this. It wasn't really specific to the pictures. The pictures don't really show what the side there's. Well, I guess the side just looks more like the kind of just a rough stone wall, so I just kind of put this in to give it a little bit more of an extra detail. It's not like too crazy that you could look at the picture and like, oh, that wasn't there. It just kind of gives it a basic stone look. So I guess it fits the actual castle's bridge somewhat. The actual castle is basically just, it's just a old stone bridge, so I think it represents it pretty well. And then as far as the kind of railing up there, I just put these slope bricks on both sides. It's pretty basic, kind of just railing on the pictures that I saw. So in the pictures, it looks like there's kind of a slanted railing, I guess. So I put those in. They seem to represent it pretty well. So for the most part, the bridge is now done. I'll just have to finish up the back area there when I'm working on. Again, there's a bridge goes up, then there's this kind of a first entrance that goes to the courtyard here, and then there's a bigger entrance. There are at least the entrance to the main castle. So bridge is mainly done, got the roads done. Now the roads all the way complete. So now there won't be any more road work other than maybe just extending cobblestone roadway. It'll go into the courtyard, but I'll probably keep this going cobblestone and have it stay cobblestone in the courtyard. So that's it so far. Now I think I'm gonna go ahead and start making some more trees. And I made a bunch of these green pine trees. Now I'm gonna make the dark green ones. Although I am running out of these trunk pieces, I probably should have ordered some more. So I'll make as many as I can, and then Alright, I'll probably have a bunch of extra green, of the green leaf pieces, but I'm also going to be using a lot if we go over back there. I'm thinking about just using those green pieces because I don't really want to put like a bunch of the grass, these types of grass pieces on the dark green because it'll kind of stand out. It won't kind of blend into the landscape. So I'm thinking about using the leaf pieces like on the trees, just on the ground, just so it doesn't make the ground look like a plain plate there. It'll just have a little bit more detail to it. So thinking leave some of the green leaves, not don't use them all on trees. I had quite a bit of these left after making the pine trees that I just made here. So I had quite a bit of these left. I'm planning that I have like 200 of these, so I should have quite a few extras at the end to keep that detail. So I'll probably go ahead, make as many trees as I can with the trunk pieces that I have so far or right now. I can always go back, just order some more trunk pieces, make more trees later. So I feel like I have enough leaves now. I probably won't have to order more of those. It's mainly just trunks now, but I'll see at the end once I make all these trees if, and then I probably won't get into placing them down this segment. That will come next time. Next week is Thanksgiving, so I think I only have 2 days of school, so I'll have a lot more time to work on the mocks. So I'll get those all the trees. This segment we finished up the road. I'll get most of the trees built that I can. Worked on the bridge. So next segment I will be placing in the trees, and then once the trees are and bushes are placed in, I will know where the grass needs to go, so then I can put in grass afterwards. I think I also will be, there's still a little bit more just ground detail, and I have some other plants that I can put in, so we'll save that for next week. So I guess this is more the part one, and then next week will be a part two, finishing up the landscape. So I'll go ahead right now, get working on the trees. I'll probably get another time lapse in for you. So I'll go ahead and keep working. Coming back for the last bit in this segment. As you saw in the last time lapse, I was building a lot of trees. I started off with these dark green ones, made three of the big ones, and then I started experimenting making smaller trees before with the green, regular green. I made these trees, but it used the smaller leaves, but you don't have the smaller leaves with the dark green. So I kind of was experimenting with how could I make a smaller a little pine tree, but just with using the bigger type of leaf. So came up with these, and I thought they turned out pretty well, and then I made this even smaller version of it. And after doing so, I realized since I had so many of these regular green left over, I made six more of these smaller versions. Again, I made three larger dark green, then four of the kind of medium ones, and two of the really small ones. So I went back to the smaller green, and then I made four or six smaller ones. So that leaves me with quite a bit more little trees in for minifigure scale. Let me put a minifigure there, show you guys. It's about two minifigures tall. The smaller trees, so decent sized. And then the more medium ones would be probably about three minifigures high. Maybe more. Or about three and a half, something like that. So, and then also, I also got a few more of these olive green, kind of little plant things. So I went ahead, I got a bunch of different little brown pieces. I started kind of experimenting with them. And I got a few different, I think I have some of these ones before, used this little plant piece. You could kind of see it. So I made three more of those. I made one of these things with kind of those pieces I had ordered earlier. Just one of those. And then I made three of these smaller things. They used that brick, three of those, and then the little torch brick. I made four of these, just has that torch brick, and then just put them on top of there. So four of those, and plus I still have a good amount more of these leaves, so, but I might just, in certain areas, just put them on the ground, just... They don't have to really have the little trunk stem thing, so our minifigure scale here is about 3/4 of the minifigure, decent size. So I still have a good amount of the greens left. I used up all my little trunk, or the bigger trunks. I still have more of the kind of medium ones, the round bricks. I left myself with a decent amount of the dark green so I can cover the ground in that back swampy area. These will probably just be for more smaller pine trees in the future. I still have a decent amount of the olive, small olive leaves left. I'll probably also sprout a little bit of those on the more swampy or just brown areas like this. Plus, I think I have some olive plates, just like little 1x2 plates that I'll spread around in little areas. So there's just kind of make some of these areas a little bit more detailed, like this area's kind of plain. I might add a little bit to that, so still a little detail things that I'm thinking about adding in. So I got basically quite a few trees in. Like I said earlier, in the next segment next week I will add those in. So I'm gonna be ending it out. This just going back what happened this segment. Started off making the green trees, then we went over and finished that back road, then worked on this top area plus the bridge. Bridge is basically complete, and then we ended it off with building these dark green trees plus some olive bushes. So decent amount of work done. I guess again, this is going to be basically part one. Next week will be part two, finishing it up by installing all these trees, bushes, and then we'll be getting, I'll probably do some of the smaller details then, like the little olive green plates, placing those around, other little details, and then we can finish up with the grass, and then at that point, we'll be getting towards the castle then, so... A good amount of work so far, and right now I got a quick question for you guys. Do you think it would be good if I started posting like part of this site. Like for this video, I worked kind of throughout the week, mainly on the weekends, and then I post a video on Sunday. Do you think it would be cool if I kind of split that in half, posted part of it on Sunday, maybe the other part midweek, like Wednesday? And another idea could be for more uploads, I could do like a weekly vehicle video, like last week, since there wasn't as much work being done, I built this Panzer IV, so, or Panzer IV winter camo. So, would you guys want me to do like a weekly vehicle, or start, or maybe not weekly, but try to get like little episodes out of, maybe try to build some more vehicles, get a video out just specifically featuring that vehicle, or not just that vehicle, but in the future do some more vehicle builds and have segments just on those. So leave your feedback in the comments, and if you like what you saw in this video, share with your friends. It helps the channel. The channel's not growing quite as fast as I thought or would want it to, so if you guys want to help out, shout outs help. Share with your friends. It all helps. So thank you guys for watching, and I hope to see you guys in the next segment.